Hello, I'm Shivangi Lohmi. I'm a legal intern at Lexis and Company. I'm from Yashwant Rao Chavan Law College, Pune, Maharashtra. My topic is Commercial Courts Act 2015. It was enacted to establish a distinct procedural framework for dealing with commercial disputes above a certain specific value. The main objective of this act is to enable a speedy redressal of commercial disputes in India. The present FAQs deal with the constitution of commercial courts and the procedure for dealing with commercial disputes in India. Commercial disputes includes any dispute arising out of commercial relationship between parties, such as mercantile documents, export and import of merchandise or services, admiralty, maritime law, aviation, infrastructure, immovable property, franchising, distributions, joint venture, insurance, etc. Its interpretation and enforcement. Further, the Act also clarifies that a commercial dispute shall not cease to be a dispute merely because of the presence of state or its instrumentalities as one of the contracting parties. Commercial court has jurisdiction to deal with any suit or application dealing with a commercial dispute arising within its territorial jurisdiction, where the value of the specified subject matter in a dispute exceeds INR 3 lakh or approximately USD 4,000. Process of mediation of commercial disputes. Once the authority appoints the mediator will decide the date and time of each mediation sitting after consulting with both the parties, which may be held jointly or separately. During the course of the mediation proceedings, both parties will make settlement proposals to the mediator. The parties can instruct the mediator regarding the extent of disclosure of their proposal by the mediator to the opposite party. Mediation process is required to be completed within 3 months from the date in which the party makes an application for mediation. A 2-month extension may be granted for the process if required. Mediation rules provide that the mediator shall be bound by the following conditions. The mediator must uphold the integrity and fairness of the mediation process and be faithful to the relationship of trust and confidentiality reposed in him by the parties. Mediator shall ensure that the parties are informed about the procedural aspects of the mediation process and must conduct the mediation in accordance with the applicable laws. The mediator is required to disclose any financial or other interest in the subject matter of the commercial dispute to the parties. Mediator must avoid impropriety while communicating with the parties and refrain from promises or guarantees of results. The mediator must recognize that the mediation is based on the principles of self-determination by the parties and their ability to reach a voluntary agreement. The mediator should not meet or communicate with the parties or their representatives' counsels privately except during the mediation sittings within the premises of the authority. The mediator should not interact with the media or publicize the details of any dispute under mediation or any other alien activity performed by him as a mediator, which may prejudice the interest of the parties to the commercial dispute. This video doesn't solicit any types of promotion or advertisements as per the guidelines of Bar Council of India. And the sole purpose of this video is for educational purposes only. Please like, share and comment on my video and do subscribe this channel. Thank you so much.